All right, everyone, Wanderbot here, and welcome back to Scrap. I don't know. Anyway, what's the plan for today? The plan for today is to keep working on this gigantic horror. I'll be done with him soon. I hope. Okay, let's hop on a lift here and see if I can finish off the sides of the... What? I was on it. Guess it wasn't. Yeah, I'm gonna see if I can finish off this gigantic monstrosity. It bugs me that the dwarves don't have shadows. It's not necessary. It's not necessary for them to have shadows. But it just... It's weird. I don't know. Anyway. This is the hard part. So, I have this. I guess. Do I do that? Do we just scale it up slowly? I could do that. I'm not entirely sure if I'm confident in that, though. Yeah, I don't think that's gonna look good in multiple ways. So let's... Yeah, I just did this, but I think I'm gonna have to rescind my progress in favor of making something that looks nice. I don't know. I'm working on it. This is, like I said, work in progress. To some degree, I almost wish... Well, Okay, so the interesting part is we've got this pattern here. So it's 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1. So what if we just follow that? So this is it. 3 up. Yeah. So I'm just gonna scale that in and we'll just make it work. Oh. One too far. Well, it'll be fine. 2. Unfortunately, the lift is too short for some of this, which is kind of a pain in the butt. Then again, I should probably get closer, or we should just get that scaffolding off. Okay, so what this is gonna do is it's going to slowly grade it up. What I should probably do is actually chop this off, like, right now. The reason why I want to chop this off right now, let's paint it the same dark gray that we're using for everything else. I'm gonna dupe this and we're gonna weld it on every single point. Okay, let's do chin rib. Yeah, I should have done this initially, but... Oh well. Anyway, so we're gonna get a couple of chin ribs here, and we're just gonna hopefully weld them on. It's straight to where it's supposed to go. Okay, so you need to be deleted. So let's see what I can do to fill this in. Let's make sure that. Okay, cool. See, what I can do is just have the same. Same shape, I just gotta make sure I just remember to put it in the right spot. It's one above what we had. There we go. Looks like it's gonna work out for us. Yeah, so this way we get kind of a gradation going up. And it should look nice. Okay, we're gonna need one more on this side. Because, yeah, I don't want to grade it too much any other way than this. I don't know, this just seems like a solid plan. This is a weird song. I don't know. No copyright sounds, everybody. But I don't know. It's not bad. I'm pretty affable about music. It's just sometimes I'll get into these and just be like, so what? Okay, also for some reason this isn't gonna let me up. Alright, maybe instead of proper scaffolding, I'm just gonna instead of bothering with the lift, let's just did this wrong. Okay, there we go. Because it's 2, 2, 3 up and around. Okay. Yeah, so I might just have like a step-based system here. Okay, there we go. So this will give us this. Though in reality, I need to extend this over a little bit or something. I don't know what the plan is. I'll just do that for the time being. All right. And I'm just going to fill this in. Because we got some stuff to do with the other side. We also got to fill in the gaps. We got to do quite a lot of things. I'm going to just start cutting this section off. We're going to do the same chin rib stuff. I think I'm going to try and fill in the belly today. I think that seems like the best, earliest option thing that I can do here. And I've got some time-saving measures, so this should go quicker. I really am sorry that my, like, insistence on making this thing look kind of cool, or at least not like a giant rectangle, is slowing this down, because I actually really would like to get back to some of my, like, random shenaniganry, and I should probably get a hold of, like, Bird and Durf and whatever, and just be like, let's play Scrap Mechanic, even though Batbeard's still dead, because I was talking to him today, and apparently he's gonna be out for, like, another week, which is rough, and, like, admittedly, we don't need Batbeard for Godzilla, but I'd feel bad if we did it without him. Okay, so let's get some ribs up in here. I don't know how many ribs I need. Lots. Speaking of, ribs is a food. Super good stuff. I don't know how many of you guys eat ribs. I've been having more since we've gotten to Kansas, and it's been good eats. Ah, shoot. Is that right? I think it is. I could always just cut it off and weld on a rib. Let's do that. The rib system is a little bit more reliable here. It turns out I didn't cut quite the right section here. Yeah, I wish I could raise and lower this thing, but that would be a bit of a technical nightmare. I'm gonna delete this too. Just in case we run into any weird welding issues. Okay, cool. There we go. So this is gonna go quick now that I'm doing some of these time-saving measures. Still gonna have to hop into the belly and start cutting stuff out. I think that'll probably be where I put some of my mechanics, maybe? I don't know. I'm not entirely sure. I'm still kind of staunchly opposed to the idea of having a whole lot of moving parts on this sucker. Just because that would be a problem. Okay, let's see. Do we? Yeah. I gotta figure out a way of getting a seat up in this sucker. Just like a means of getting in and on. Well, I'm gonna very awkwardly try and climb inside of his face, fail miserably, and consider my options. Because once we get the belly, it's not a problem. It's just until then, getting into this sucker sucks. Okay, there we go. I'm gonna just delete that. There we go. Okay, so we're in the belly. Let's get this working. Okay, so no, we want to keep this. We don't want any of this. Oh, this is gonna be a problem. Like so. Yeah, this is a prabble. I mean, it's not a big prabble. It's a that's a new one. Let's think. I guess we might as well paint all this in. I can fix that one rib. Let's get rid of this. I'll have to figure out, wrong direction. Okay, yeah, I'll have to figure this out. Because, honestly, there's nothing against me having a, there's nothing against me having a big solid block on the front here, but I'm trying to cut, to make this thing lose as much weight as possible, which is an issue. We could just fill in the gaps here temporarily. I guess it won't be so bad if I just remember to, if I cut it out. Because, yeah, I want this sucker to be hollow. Grab it from here. No, I don't think I can. Whatever, I'll get it in a second. Okay, so yeah, let's, I'm gonna cut this out for the time being. Because they're all gonna match. Makes this easier. And this is why having a good plan before you start going is actually a really good idea. If you don't have that good plan, you kind of end up just wasting a lot of your time. And this is definitely one of those situations where some planning ahead would have actually made this entire build so much easier. At least it's not, like, too hard to recover. Just a bit of a pain in the butt. Okay, I mean, the other thing is, we could actually cut off one of these inner ribs and just weld it in. No problem. At least having access to this inner section is actually going to make it way easier to, can I get up here? Yeah, I can. To, like, paint and get around and add some of these things. Also, the other thing is, if I want to go, like, well, I guess we're down here. And, now that we've done this, now that we've cut some of this stuff out, we're not gonna have issues. Okay, cool. Yeah, I can put seat blocks like right here. Oh, you're the wrong spot. Okay, I'm just gonna put one right here. Get me in. I'm gonna fill that layer for a second. We're gonna just put the two seat blocks here. I'll have them be slightly grayer or something, so it's obvious where they are. Let's see. Anyway, yeah, we're gonna wanna make sure we have easy access to the insides of this guy. Just because I would prefer not to have an open air belly. I was considering using glass, actually. But I'm not entirely sure if that would be wise. It'd be really heavy. I don't know if you guys remember, well, I assume a number of you guys remember my Minecraft slime. That thing was awesome, but very heavy. It's part of the reason why I'm making this. As much as I like my Minecraft slime, there's a very real possibility he's going to be invincible. You know, somebody's gonna hit it with a plane and it's just gonna donk. Because there's no easy way to damage the thing, it can flip over really easily. I mean, that's part of the problem with the original Darth Slugula design, is that it's particularly impervious to harm because it just flips itself back over. And getting it to stop is a small nightmare. And so this is kind of my response to my my ridiculously overpowered design of making something even more ridiculous, but possibly less overpowered? We'll see. I honestly don't have a whole lot of my I don't have a whole lot of confidence in myself in making something that isn't going to just be wildly unfair to everybody else competition-wise, but what am I supposed to do? I guess not do it, but, like, go big or go home. Like, that literally is my save file for this one. And it's gonna be my creed. Not that I need a creed, but, I mean, go big, go home. Why not? How often do you get to make giant murder space whales? The answer is most people never will. Me? It's my job. I would like to organize like a free build though. Even if we're not gonna get Batbeard back, it would be fun to do like a free build session again just so I have some multiplayer. Even if it is me just messing with this and Bird messing with other things in the background, and then we all get together to be like, this is what we did. Like, that'd be nice actually. Cause I will admit, I actually find myself dreading working on this sucker a little bit, just because, you know. It's a huge undertaking. Okay, I'm just gonna be running between different tasks here. Is that the right coloration? Awesome. Okay, let's keep emptying this out. I know I'm gonna be filling this back in almost immediately. What's going on? Something's wrong with it. Oh, I know what's wrong with it. I'm running a video and it's just finishing the render. Sorry about this. Yeah, I don't like doing this either. This is one of the rough points about recording anything midday. Let's see. Well, as far as I remember, these are like nearly identical both directions. Okay, there we go. Yeah, I gotta be better about painting these. So I'm just gonna paint. Every dark segment I can get to. Okay. Or gray segment, I don't know. We should have done this from the beginning, maybe. Oh well. Not like it takes very long, but this way, I absolutely won't accidentally... I won't accidentally delete any of the pieces I'm working with. Should probably make sure it extends all the way up to the top. And if we paint a little bit into the chin, no biggie. But yeah, I find myself not looking forward to this to some degree. Just because I do miss playing with my friends. It's just... I've mentioned this before, now that Bird's working, he's only available for like 2 hours every night, and we got other things to play. I've always felt bad for making the guy more or less be my sidekick for this series for a whole year. And he probably doesn't exactly see it that way, but, you know, I do. And I prefer to make my friends, you know, play a variety of things, so they're not bored. Imagine if you had one friend that was like, Let's play Halo every single time you ever interacted with him. Just Halo, or Call of Duty, or whatever. Whatever game it is, he only ever wants to play one of them. Like, after a certain point, you'd be like, I want to play something new. And he's like, but I want to play Halo. Or, I need to play Halo. And it's just like, pass? Yeah, I don't want to be that guy. And I'm going to be totally honest, I am that guy. And it's awful. Sort of. I feel awful. I guess it's not actually awful, but still. Okay. Yeah, this'll work out. Of course, I'm going to be filling this in almost immediately, but still. Why is one of these jut out more than the other ones? I'll have to look into that. Okay. Well, I think we're pretty much done with the chin. I really almost do like the idea of having this be hollow. Or filled with glass. Maybe I'll do a an alternative build at some point. Or, you know, just material update the body. I don't know if I could do that easily. Actually, you know what? I might actually hand this to Durf and see if he can convert the entire thing over to the, like, really nice painted glass blocks that they added with one of the more recent updates. Because that could look really sweet, now that I'm thinking about it. Just like a glass whale. A glass murder whale. That'd be fun. Okay, so yeah. It's actually really easy to fill this thing in with white blocks. The only problem is going to be... filling it in is going to be a bit of a pain in the butt. Well, not filling it in, painting it? I guess painting's not so bad, though, because I don't have any overlaps here, so it makes it a little bit easier. Getting the sides is probably going to be the hardest part, because we've already finished this section. Actually, you know what? This is a lot easier than I was thinking it would be. All I have to do is just make sure it matches here. Wow, this is... okay, this is way easier. Because, yeah, as long as I just overlap it like this, no problem. It's going to be a little bit time-consuming down this path. I guess I could, like, kind of figure out some weldable side section, but... don't think I'm going to do that. To some degree, too much optimization ends up being more time-consuming than not. We've also got this, like, upper section here. I don't know what I'm going to do with that. I'm just going to ignore it for the time being as though it doesn't exist. And I'll figure it out. We're gonna have to take a look at what this thing looks like from the outside anyway. Cause we've got some holes here that are gonna need filling. I guess that's still a rather easy fix. Okay, let's go take a look at this from the outside just to make sure it's kind of what we're going for. Yeah, it's got a really nice, oh god. I don't know if you guys go to the oddly satisfying subreddit, but this is oddly satisfying just seeing, like, them line up and stuff. I don't know what it's called. I know there's a phrase that perfectly describes that effect, and like pareidolia, is what's popping in my head. But I know that's not the case. I don't know. I'd have to look at it. I need to learn some more of those, like, big words that describe weird things, because some of those could actually be kind of handy when describing shit. Because I suck at that part. Pretty much it. Every time I have to, like, describe something to somebody else, they're just like, "What are you talking about, Wanderbot?" And I'm just like, "Look, I'm trying here. I'm trying to use these real human words that the rest of you real humans use." But then again, I got shit for that when I was younger too, because I used too many big words, and everybody's just like, "Huh?" Yeah, I don't know. I was reading really big books by the time I was in, like, fourth grade, and I'm gonna say it was good for me, but I'm also gonna say it probably didn't do me a whole lot of favors with my peers who are still reading much lower than me. Completely missed the young adult fiction genre, pretty much. For better or worse, I'm not entirely sure. Okay, let's just fill in these gaps this way. I've been trying to go back and find some, like, actually good young adult fiction, just because some of them tend to be a little bit happier. I really like fiction, but god, the fiction genre is, like, the least, it's, like, the least I don't know. It's never happy. I mean, then again, this is true of, like, a lot of genres, honestly. They tend to be super dour and unhappy. Obviously, mystery is almost always just, like, straight-up murders or, like, backstabbing and stuff. But, like, I don't know, Game of Thrones is, like, super unhappy all the time. Walking Dead, super unhappy all the time. The Expanse, relatively unhappy all the time. Just, I don't know. It just seems like nothing can ever go right in those books, and it's just like, I don't know, I like reading things where things go okay for people. You know, somebody just doesn't outright die right off the bat, somebody important or whatever. And I mean, if they do, at least kind of give them a good send-off. Let's see. Yeah, so I guess the next thing we're going to do, after we fill this in and paint it, is we're going to want to, we're going to want to cut a hole in the section above us, because we need to actually be able to upgrade, we want to access the upstairs. And honestly, we don't need that much extra space, weight, whatever. I mean, it's a bit of both. We need space, not because we need it, but just because it'd be nice. Any amount of, like, chaff that I could cut off would be nice. I don't think I'm going to rib the inside here. I could. Like, we could cut out lines here forever, wherever these gray ones are. But I don't think I want to do that, just because it makes walking kind of awkward. And I'd prefer to be able to move around in this thing without too many issues. If at all possible. I wonder what's faster. Probably pulling towards you in this game. Yeah, probably. Gotta make sure I fill this in right. Yeah, we still gotta figure out what we're gonna do with the side. Besides, I have half a temptation to just, I mean, we could just fill it in. I don't know. I'll fill in what I got, and then we'll see what it looks like from the outside. The other thing is, we could just leave the body, like, the yellow cream. But I don't think I want to do that either. Okay, I've been playing too many survival games where, like, battery management is a thing. Like, you know, power. I looked over and saw Durf-Slugula, and I'm like, shit, I should go turn off the lights so I don't waste my batteries. I have a problem. Yeah, Subnautica, that's the one that gets me. The lights consume power, and I am terrible at... Okay, pulling towards you is so much more efficient here. I really should probably do both, now that I'm thinking about it. Really, as long as it requires no movement, it's best, but pulling towards you seems to be the most efficient method of filling in blocks. I guess it makes sense. But still. Okay, how long have we been going for? Really only half an hour. Feels like hours. But then again, it's big and it's mildly monotonous. Yeah, go figure, I'm starting to think maybe I should do like a multiplayer thing. Oh. What? I'm very confused. I'm gonna have to check that out. Let's check it out right now. How does the underside of all this look? Normal. Very confusing. Yeah, I'm gonna say it fairly definitively looks better along the center, but there's not really much I can do with the ribbing otherwise. It looks really nice, though. So, I'm not going to regret what I've done. Here's the thing. I was considering doing this in white. I think let's rethink that idea. Maybe this red. I think this red is probably the best possible. I really wish there was a way to just like point at a group of blocks and be like, paint. I gotta be careful with this, though. I could actually be painting some of the ribs on the outside, so I gotta only color in the appropriate color zones. Otherwise, we're gonna have prables. I don't know how many prables, but we might have prables. Might also have to check my painting from the outside. Luckily, I haven't layered a single thing on this build for the most part. So, or have I? Oh, this is the only section where I've done layering. Okay, yeah, so I'll have to do quality control from the outside. But I've done fairly minimal layering. Should make this easier. But yeah, if we give him a blood red belly, that should actually look really nice and... Because I was considering white just because, but... I think white is a bit of a waste here. Because this is supposed to be one of the Slugula family. And the Slugula family is not exactly what I call the prettiest. So we should probably start working on making him look a little bit more, menacing? Yeah. So yeah, let's go with the blood red. Because I think that's probably the best possible option. Okay. Let's see. This is gonna take a while, but it's not gonna take as long as it coulda. I've at least built in the right way that it should save some time. Still probably would have been maybe faster if I'd learned how to like weld all this shit together with copy and pasting. But I get the feeling I probably would have spent most of my time trying to puzzle it out, and that could have been like a serious slowdown as far as things go. Plus, this goes pretty fast. Ish. Yeah, so we'll have to come in and probably or pop out and repaint some of these ribs. Okay, so there's a couple of spots that we'll miss. And yeah, if you notice I've painted over some of the ribs along the way. Okay, so let's start filling in these holes again. Yeah, the red was absolutely the right kind of idea. Actually, in retrospect, I should just be able to do like this, yeah? Yeah, there we go. Okay, so that solves all problems. I just gotta make sure I don't go too far. There we go. Okay. So, I'm just gonna make this section darker. It blends in pretty well, but it should be easier to find this way. Okay. Let's see. So let's just fill these in. Because, yeah, I want this guy to look relatively intimidating. I think. And I think I'm getting there. He still looks pretty comical. Don't get me wrong. But we're well on the way to kind of what I'm going for. Or trying to go for. I don't know. Anyway, next trick. Let's just cut this out for the time being. I'll probably add like a platform system on the inside so we have some places to like walk through. But there's no reason why we should have this, like, ceiling. Unless I wanted to have, like, extra layers. I mean, the one thing is, as a joke, if this thing flies really well, and I can get it to, like, maneuver fairly slowly, I would not actually be opposed to making some kind of, like, Dr. Doolittle. I think it was Dr. Doolittle. Style. Like, house? House whale? I'd probably want to, update it so it doesn't look super creepy and intimidating. But, you know, actually putting, like, living quarters and, like, an engine room and shit in here. That'd be funny. Oh, yeah. And if it can actually run on the server without lagging too bad, we could even have it in conjunction with, like, a Skybase and have this be a, like, a delivery mechanism or something cool like that. I'd be down. And then we could decorate it and have it be super nice. Or everybody could make, like, a base ship. Because I actually really enjoyed making planes with these guys. But what if we all made, like, motherships? That would take multiple sessions. You know what? I'm shooting for Godzilla by episode 390. Motherships could be episode 400. That'd be fun. You know, a ship capable of quote-unquote housing a dwarf. As just a sort of cosmetic build thing. Because we usually do mechanical, but what if we did, like, you know, floating bases and stuff? Oh, it'd be really funny. Forcing everybody to make, like, somewhat neutrally buoyant ships or something, and then telling them to go up. Oh, that'd be perfect. Okay. This is an idea now. I need to remember to do this. If I'm streaming and I'm trying to think of an idea and I've got the whole group together, remind me, please. So let's outline it. So everybody makes a floating platform, or maybe I make a maybe I make the base. But effectively, what it would be is we have these like floating islands that float, you know, somewhere up. Like a little bit, and it's got like a stability glitch and whatnot. But without touching the ceiling or the ground, you have to make a base. Like a flying base or whatever. And obviously they're gonna teeter, they're gonna totter, they're gonna fall over and shit like that. Which is exactly what I'd want. It'd be really funny if you have to make like a house flying thing without upending the whole thing. And obviously, like, you could make jury-rigged fixes on the fly. Oh, I like this idea. It's a great way to combine one of our dumb challenges with, one of our dumb challenges with the, you know, a more aesthetic build. It's like the bathroom cars Bird and I made, except for maybe a little bit more well-reasoned. Those were kind of stupid. Okay. Well, I think this is actually a pretty good stopping point, all things considered. Obviously, we've still got a crap ton of things to do, but I'm satisfied. Here, let's get up on the lift. Let's get a better view of this guy for once. Oh, let's get rid of the tower boxes. We don't need it anymore. If I still needed it, I wouldn't delete it, but from what I remember, we really don't need a scaffolding on the outside for the time being. We might not even need a scaffolding again if I'm going to be able to get back into this guy's belly freely. But yeah, this should work out great. And then we'll do that challenge idea, and that'll be fun. I don't know. I'll figure it out. Either way, see you guys in the next episode of Scrap Mechanic. And as always, thanks for watching.